Hey guys, it's Ben. I'm going to do another paydirt review. Figure why not, if I'm going to pan it, I might as well make a video about it. So today we're doing the Goldn Paydirt Jackpot paydirt. Tell you a little bit about them. I've used Goldn Paydirt before. I got the regular large bags of the regular and the nugget reserve. And the regular I was really disappointed in. I just didn't find much. I may give it a try one day, but not right now. The nugget reserve, I didn't get a whole lot of gold, but I got a lot more than the other bag, and it was nice gold. You know, it was chunkier gold, like pickers and stuff. So I enjoyed it. It was a lot more fun. And in this order, I did a big bag of nugget, 10. I think it's a 10-pound bag of nugget reserve. Give that one another shot. And I'm doing the jackpot pay dirt. Now the jackpot pay dirt I've never done before. Supposedly, you know, like they always say, well, one bag may have a whole lot of gold. But we'll just have to see about that. So I'm going to go ahead and do some scoops. Now, if you look outside where I usually do my panning in the backyard, it is dark. It is already nighttime. So the lighting may not be that great. I do have a light I'm going to put on it. And we'll do just little bits and pieces of it at a time. So I'll try to do those pieces with good light. But man, it's Friday night and I've had a crappy week and I hadn't panned in weeks. And it's kind of like a form of meditation for me, you know, with a little reward at the end. So it comes in a priority mailbox. They combine bags. If you get a 2-for-1 that's 5 pounds, you're going to get a 10-pound bag. That's how they do it. Real quick, I'm going to show you how they package it. As you can see, it comes in this monster thick. They really do a great job packaging. This monster thick Ziploc bag. It's huge. And if you look, it's actually double bagged. So this is in a thinner bag, but it's still quite thick. You'll never get spilled dirt in your box with this type of packaging. So that's a good thing. At least it won't get wasted. So I'm going to go ahead and do some classifying and do some panning, and we'll go over the results. Take care. All right, so here's my plus 10, guys. Let me zoom in. As you can see, there's absolutely nothing. So that's my plus 10. We'll keep on working. Okay, so here's my plus 20. Still nothing really stellar. Got a little decent sized piece right there. Just one, though. Hopefully my camera will eventually focus on it, but let me pull back. But you can see where it is, and that's my finger compared to it. That's the plus 20. All right, well, there's your minus 20, plus 30. Three small specks. So far, I'm not feeling this bag, but we'll keep moving. Okay, guys, so here's the minus 30, plus 40. Finally getting a little color. I don't know if you can see that there. There we go. Not a lot, but getting something at least. That's my thumb in comparison. So that's the minus 30, plus 40. We got one or two batches left to go. Okay, so the minus 40, plus 50. I used my little baby bowl for this one. And rightfully so, because I don't even know if you can see this. That. Let me see, right there, if you can even see that speck, I had to break out my loop just to determine if it was gold. That is the gold that I got from there. Really not feeling this, guys. Alright guys, so there's my minus 50, and as you can see, it's completely empty. So this was about 5 or 6 scoops from the bag, which looked to be about half the bag. I'm hoping it's not half the bag, because damn, that was pretty poor. So I'm gonna go weigh the bag and see how much is left in it. I believe it was 10 pounds or a little over. The weight was good, but we'll check it out quickly. This is all I've come up with. That's not too pretty. I did weigh the bag, and it came out to be about 7 pounds. So, being it's a 10-pound bag, And it was a legit 10 pounds. It looks like I've done maybe a third of the bag. So there's more left. But, God, there better be more than... There better be more than twice this left. I would hope that it would be at least a gram in there. I'm going to look up and see what I paid for this. I don't remember, but I thought it was a lot. Maybe I'm tripping, but I'll find out the cost and see what a reasonable amount would be. Usually I kind of expect in a big bag like that to get at least a gram of gold. So I'll be back with you. Actually, you know what? Let's weigh this out.
Okay.
Then just take the filter. If there's black sand, I'll try to pull it out, but this doesn't really have much. I don't think that's going to make much of a difference. I use these coffee filters maybe 2-3 times each. I mean, I have a bunch, so I could do it, and I don't use them, so I could do it every time. I just get lazy, but I wouldn't use them more than that. You don't want to rip and lose your gold. All right, so get that in there. Make sure we got it all. Got a couple little pieces there. So from this little 5 to 6 scoops, about 3 pounds. I got 0.03 grams. So three hundredths of a gram. So that's where we are here. Guys, I think what I'm going to do is, just to be fair to Goldn Paydirt, I'm going to go ahead and pan out the rest of that bag tomorrow when I have a little bit more time. And get a final gold count and weigh that out. This you know, it may have just been that this pan was disappointing. That does happen sometimes, even in a good bag. You get a real disappointing pan. So let me be fair and do the entire 10-pound bag. I'll try to get it done tomorrow, and then we'll come back and we'll weigh that out, and then I'll give you a more honest review. Okay? Hey guys, it's Ben. I'm back. Just finished the Jackpot bag. It was a 10-pound bag. I'm going to weigh in the last bit of pan, and then we'll weigh all of it that I found and put it together. There were a few specks of gold I found in an old pan and stuff like that. I wasn't sure if it was from the Jackpot bag, but to be fair, because I was so negative earlier, I went ahead and added them to this. It wasn't much. It was like 0.05 gram of gold, but I went ahead and gave them the benefit of the doubt because there was only two different brands that I was going with, and one of them was the $1,400 Lynch mining bucket, which was full of gold, and then the Jackpot. And I figured since it was in this little small pan, it was probably from the Jackpot. If not, it's a 0.05 difference. So I'm going to go ahead and weigh this in. And then we're going to weigh the total, and I'm going to give you my final opinion on this Goldn Paydirt Jackpot 10-pound bag. So we're looking at 0.0853, and that was my last pan of gold. And I did find a nice little picker. It's like a little cylinder. It's pretty cool looking. So we're at 0.83. I'm going to pour the rest of what I found in here. There's a nice little picker, had a good weight, almost 0.6. You'll see that, right? Well, maybe not. There we go. Get in there. Okay, there's my picker. So we're looking at 0.766 grams from that 10-pound Jackpot bag. Let me see what the zero this out. I want to see what this little nugget weighed. It was 0.48, so it was about half a gram. It's pretty cool. I'll see if the camera will focus on it. You can see it's kind of like a cylinder. It's been worn like that. I like that. So it's a neat one. I'll keep it for my collection. But the 0.766 is the total from the 10-pound Jackpot bag. I'm going to go look at what I paid for it and give you an estimate on that. I'll be right back. All right, guys. So I finished checking on the price on that. So we had 0.766 grams of gold in a 10-pound bag of the Jackpot pay dirt, and I paid on sale with like a 25% discount or whatever from the sale price. The price being $104.99 minus $26.24, that gave me $78.75, I believe, for a 10-pound bag of the Jackpot. And at 0.766 grams recovery, we're looking at about a 39-40% return on investment. Now, the pay darts that I prefer usually have at least about a 70% return on investment. You know, just to recoup, so it's not so expensive. I don't think I would normally even try anything that would have at least 50% return on investment. This one's 40, so I can't recommend that at all. Now, you might get the Jackpot bag, which is 1 out of 3 or something like that. But I've never had that, so I don't know that they even exist. If they do, great. Leave it in the comments just to give them a little bit of positive review. I'm not trying to poo-poo on any company, but, you know, and I have a Nugget Reserve bag as well that I'm going to take a look at. My last Nugget Reserve bag was pretty decent, but this Jackpot bag, I'm very unhappy with it. I had one decent little half-gram picker in there out of a 10-pound bag and a 40% investment return. So I can't say that I would buy that again. Even if there is a Jackpot involved, I don't think I would take that risk. There are other companies, other brands that I know, and there's some that you even have a guarantee of about an 80% return on investment at a minimum. So, and I haven't tried that one yet, but I'm about to. So, I don't know, kind of shy away from this Jackpot bag. We'll take a look at the Nugget Reserve and see what that looks like next. But that's my opinion on the Jackpot. And if you have had better experiences, please leave them in the comments just to give them a fair shake. But if not, well, I'd probably stay away from it. So, that's my review on the Jackpot. Hope you guys have a great day. Hope you've enjoyed the video. Tried to keep it short. So take care, and we'll see you soon. Bye-bye.